for his what?
Mercy.
Mercy's what?
Endureth forever.
All right. Okay. I want to see how loud y'all can say that tonight. Y'all shout that out.
Praise the Lord.
All right, you think that was loud enough to say ambushment? Y'all think that's strong enough for ambushment? Your ambushment power?
Yes.
Well, people have all kind of ideas as how much it takes and what intensity your praise got to be before you get the ring. You know, we have all, some say, well, all you have to do is just do it back this way. Yeah, some say you got to do it this way, some say you got to do it this way. So it's just kind of up to every individual, I guess. Amen. But it's not going to work until it's at a certain what level, though. Amen. All right. Now, I'm glad we had a chance to read those stories, because everything that you're going to read under praise God for what you're believing for is going to be based on those two stories that we just read pretty well. Because all of them are focusing on, if you want deliverance, it's like Jonah, you got to offer that what? Sacrifice. You got to what? Praise God for that
before
it takes place.
Yes.
The moment Jonah offered the sacrifice of thanksgiving, God spoke to the fish. Amen. Praise God. So God, if you want God to speak to your fish, whatever holding you, whatever your adversity is, whatever your crisis, whatever you're confronted, amen, you got to offer that what? Sacrifice. Now, one more illustration about Jesus. That's how Jesus operated.
I have a question for you. This same one on Jehoshaphat.
Okay.
You said all of the ingredients that were present with them, we're going to encounter when we are faced with them. One of the things in this, and I don't think we read it tonight, was I believe Brother Rod alluded to it, fear. In verse 3, it says in chapter 20, and Jehoshaphat feared.
Uh-huh.
He had fear too, initially. And then he set himself to seek the Lord. Because these three powerful armies were staring him in the face.
Mm-hmm.
So there was his initial thing was fear.
Mm-hmm.
But then, after then, he set himself to seek the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
So we...
So Jehoshaphat was real scared too. So how did he get rid of his fear?
He set himself to seek the Lord.
All right, set himself to what?
Seek the Lord.
And all of those things that happened, they sought the Lord, they fasted, and then he prayed that prayer that called God in remembrance. Then he heard that prophet that helped to eliminate probably a little bit more fear. And then he started what? Worshiping the Lord. And then the people began to praise, the Levites began to praise the Lord and the people with a what? Loud voice. Amen. All of that was working on that fear, right? Eliminating that fear and helping them to overcome so their faith would work and the blessings and their deliverance would come. All right. Anything else before we move further? Now, another thing you can read about is Jesus, how he operated. Remember, before he multiplied, I think he had 2 fish, 5 loaves of bread. And before he even attempted to do that, he did what? He prayed and he did what? Gave thanks.
Yes.
Y'all notice that?
Yes.
He prayed and then he what?
Gave thanks.
All right, before he called Lazarus forth from the dead, turn to that scripture. You can see the same thing. So Jesus always rejoiced when he was in the midst of a crisis. All right, Luke. That's John.
Yes, John.
John 12.
Yeah.
Okay, John 11. That's okay. Let's look at 35, Jesus wept, then said the Jews, behold how he loved him. This was right after he got there. Who was dead? He was dead. Some of them said, could not this man which opened the eyes of the blind have caused that even this man should not have died? Jesus therefore, again groaning in himself, coming to the grave, it was a cave, and a stone lay upon it. Jesus said, take ye away the stone. Martha, the sister of him that was dead, saith unto him, Lord, by this time he stinketh, for he hath been dead 4 days. Jesus said to her, said I not unto thee that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God? Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid, and Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I what?
Thank thee
that thou hast what?
Heard me.
All right, that was before he prayed.
Yes.
Thank Father, you. I thank thee that you have already what?
Heard me.
You've already heard me. That kind of deep, ain't
it? Amen.
Thank you, Father. You've already what?
Heard me.
You've already heard me. All right? And I knew that thou hearest me always, but because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me. And when he thus had spoken, he cried with a soft voice.
Loud voice.
Y'all didn't get it. He cried with a soft voice.
Loud voice.
All right, what did he cry? What did he say?
Lazarus, come forth.
Lazarus,
come forth.
And he that was dead came forth, bound hand and foot with grave clothes, and his face was bound about with a napkin. Jesus said unto them, loose him and let him go. It doesn't seem like he did a whole lot of praying here, did it? Seemed like he gave thanks and what?
Spoke
the word. All right, so that's a good lesson for us. You won't have to do a whole lot of praying. Amen. If you can learn how to what? Rejoice real good. Delight real good. Because the scripture says if we delight ourselves in the Lord, he will what?
Give us
the desires of our heart. Hallelujah. Praise God. So the secret is in cultivating a real rich sense of what? Thanksgiving. And let's learn how to praise him for the things that he has done. Because if we can praise him for the things that he has done, now in this book, you can turn to sections in this book and you can kind of recapitulate times in the past that God has brought you through. Different situations and circumstances and problems, open doors and made ways. If you can recapture many of those instances where you can see that God was definitely involved in your deliverance, in those circumstances, it will definitely build your faith to a level that will enable you to what? To believe him of the things that you are confronting. And that's the reason why you can say, Lord, thank you for my healing. Thank you, Lord, for meeting my need. Because you have seen him work 100 times in the past, right?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So why not give him thanks as if the thing has already been done?
That's right.
You can do it.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. So I want you to go through these scriptures now. As you go through these scriptures, on your own, you can see how all of these scriptures are admonishing you to get into a habit of praising God for the things that you are believing him for. The first thing you always do, you find a scripture that promises you what you are believing him for. Right? Find a scripture. And after you locate that scripture, say, God, this is what you promised. And I'm just going to what? Offer to you the sacrifice of what? Thanksgiving. Amen. And Hebrews 13:15 talks about the sacrifice of praise. All right. And you have several of them. My favorite is Joel 2:21. Fear not, O land, be glad and rejoice, for the Lord will do what?
Great things.
Yes. Amen. So these scriptures are very rich, and they've been selected. I went back to the Old Testament and just saw how God delivered people under the Old Covenant. All of them were basically delivered the same way. They were able to get their faith to a level where they could praise God for what they were believing for. And when they got their faith to a level, amen, that helped them to overcome all of their fear and doubt and unbelief in the circumstances, then their sacrifice kicked in and the answer and the blessings were released. Amen. So maybe these scriptures will have a different meaning as you go over them from this point.